Hello everyone. Today we are going to cover the topic of project monitoring and control. So this is the last phase of project management process. And there are many steps involved in this project monitoring and control process. We'll see them, each one of them in detail. So let's see, basically the monitoring and control where the project manager spends most of his time, right? And the last phase was... And the last phase, that was of execution, where the project team members spend most of its time, right, in delivering the project. But the project manager's main involvement is in the project monitoring and control. So while the team is busy in executing and delivering the project, the project managers are busy in monitoring and controlling work. Okay, they are busy in monitoring the project. So the main activity in monitoring and controlling starts with the integration of all the knowledge areas those are involved in the project management, in the project work, right? Making sure that all of the bits and pieces, the schedule, the time, the quality, the cost, making sure that each and every knowledge area is being properly implemented, right? That is the work of project manager at monitoring and controlling cost. So project and controlling project work is bestified through these remaining stages or these remaining processes which we'll be covering now. So the first one starts with performing integrated change control. Now what is this? This is nothing but in this we or the project manager make sure that all the changes are being properly processed and documented, right? So that's like all the changes are integrated, means when we look at the project through integrated channel, that central has to be there, that all the changes are being integrated well. I have been combined together and that then make seeing that how this each change and the total change in all, in total, how does it impact the project? And no project in the sense, how does it impact the budget or the cost? And then we look at all the changes for scope, for time, for cost, for HR, for procurement, for quality and so on. So we see that change, integrated change and the isolated change, and they impact on all the areas, right? And then we ensure that all the changes are fully integrated and all changes are addressed and documented through the performed integrated change control. Then next thing which we talk about is verifying scope. Verifying scope means this verifying scope is always focused on acceptance. Acceptance in the sense that we ensure the work, the quality of the work, the focus of the work, and ensuring about the depth and breadth of the work being done is focused for its acceptance, because the ultimate aim of any project is to get accepted at the end. Whatever the outcome is there, that should be acceptable in the end, right? So this focuses on that acceptance aspect. So validating that all of the deliverables of the project will meet the project requirements, defining the project's final acceptance, right? So this is the work of the verifying scope, because it focuses on the accepting the final deliverable of the project. Then if we talk about control, it includes your scope, budget and time. I forgot to mention here budget. There is budget also here. So it focuses on scope, budget and time. So controlling that scope is appropriate, and we do that thing thorough integrated change control, right? So verifying that we are still on the budget and that the project remains on schedule. That means if a project was supposed to complete in 6 months, so whether we will be successfully delivering it within 6 months or not, we are making sure that we are within the budget, we'll be finishing off the project within the budget or the cost which we had assigned. We won't be going beyond that. Then next is your perform quality control. Perform quality control means इन प्रोजेक्ट एग्जीक्यूशन वी फोकस ऑन प्रोजेक्ट क्वालिटी एश्योरेंस, बस बट हियर वी फोकस ऑन आर वी डूइंग द थिंग्स राइट, आर वी डूइंग द थिंग्स राइट मीन्स इट फोकसेस ऑन वेरीफाइंग द स्कोप, हैविंग मूविंग टूवर्ड्स द एक्सेप्टेंस दैट इफ यू आर डूइंग थिंग्स राइट देन ऑब्वियसली इट विल लीड अस टूवर्ड्स द एक्सेप्टेंस. देन कम्स योर रिपोर्टिंग परफॉर्मेंस. रिपोर्टिंग परफॉर्मेंस इज नथिंग बट वेन वी आर ट्राइंग टू टेल एवरी वन हू एवर इज इन्वॉल्व और द टॉप मैनेजमेंट एंड सबऑर्डिनेट्स द प्रोजेक्ट दैट हाउ प्रोजेक्ट इज गोइंग, यू नो वट इज द प्रोग्रेस ऑफ द प्रोजेक्ट, इन विच डायरेक्शन प्रोजेक्ट इज गोइंग. सो वी आर कलेक्टिंग, वी आर प्रोसेसिंग एंड वी आर डिसेमिनेटिंग द इंफॉर्मेशन रिगार्डिंग द परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ द प्रोजेक्ट. So the stats, the progress measurement, and the forecast of the project, what we are going through, executing, communicating everything to the outworld. So that is outworld in the sense to all the stakeholders who have a stake in the project. So that is your reporting performance. And then we have monitoring and control risk. See, monitoring and control risk, we talk about. We are making sure that we are actively looking at the risk radar. That means we are continuously checking or keeping a track or keeping an eye on the risk which might somehow influence the project. So we are focusing on the items in our risk radars, means we are monitoring the risk and doing proper risk management whenever and wherever required. Other than that, there is a last step involved in monitoring and control, and that is your contract compliance. Contract compliance means finally ensuring that for all the goods and services and the supplies, raw material, the products have been purchased for our project. That means whatever the requirement is there for any kind of supplies or product or raw material, those have been properly purchased. So let's see each one of them in detail now. Each of these steps in detail. First is integrated change control. That means it involves managing all the changes, right? So your change can be a large change also, and it can be a small change also. Large change needs to be managed separately. These are to be documented separately. These are, we have to see the impact of each large scale independently, and then whatever the ramifications are there of the change, uske liye jo approval hame leni hai, everything is to be done on a separate level or independently it is to be taken care of. And how to define whether it is a large change or it is a small change? So large change can be defined on the basis of the if more than X days are involved. X can be, you can decide. It can be 100 days or 360 days. So any project, if it involves, suppose for matter we have decided in our organization, if a project involves more than 365 days or 400 days, it would be considered as a large one. So any change, if it requires 100 days or 200 days in making a change in the project, then that would be considered as a large change. But or you can also define it on in the basis of the capital. If so and so, if it involves more than Y capital. Y capital means if that change will involve more than suppose 10 lakhs or 15 lakhs, 20 lakhs, then it would be considered as a large change. Now talking about the small change, it can be managed with a running change. Running change means nothing to be done in isolation or nothing to be done independently. You can just, as a part of your routine working, it keeps on running, your normal routine work, and as simultaneously it can be accommodated, that change can be accommodated, right? So like if you have to change some color, be it of product or be of raw material or be it of interiors, you are changing the packaging color from red to green, Or suppose you are changing the location, there's those plugs which were on the left side, now you are moving them to right side. So these are some of the small changes. And these are going to be project specific, right? So these are very tiny and insignificant. So these very minor, they have almost zero impact on the project or the project schedule. Because उससे project schedule पे कुछ change नहीं होता है. आपने color red से green change कर दिया है, कोई position location left से right change कर दी है. So it is not affecting your budget, it is not affecting your schedule. But what would happen? But it truly has an impact on the project deliverable. Final जो आपका deliverable आएगा, when you will combine all these changes, small changes together, it will have an impact on the final project outcome. So what do? We maintain, or the project managers, they maintain a spreadsheet, independent spreadsheet, in which at the end of the month, all those small changes will be consolidated, will be merged together, and will be presented as one larger scale for approval and for acceptance, right? So जब उसको monthly at the end of the month will be consolidating it, वो small small changes जो हैं वो इतने, it would become a significant change that it would be needing some approvals also. So we are talking about all, not some, but all the changes or any change for any pre-approved documented project fact. So scope, direction, team, quality needs to be, you know, these all have to be documented together, and these need to be integrated in the project change process, right? After that, we have integrate changes into the project. See, changes have already been made. If changes have been made, these need to be integrated also. Integrated in the sense, it needs to be integrated in the, you need to fit those changes in the schedule and budget also. So when changes are approved, it must be integrated in the schedule. Right, and it will make changes to your budget also. Similarly, the budget also and the cost also, because the additional labor you are putting in, ya ho sakta uske liye koi additional material aapko chahiye ya supply aapko chahiye. So for that matter, what will happen, it will have an impact on budget also, and that is total cost as well. Then we have the risk. See, when you are introducing some changes or you are adding these new changes, it is bringing up some new risk to the project, in which case new risk plan projects are to be made. So if something new is getting added up, new risk is coming up, you need to make a new risk plan project. So new risk plan project needs to be developed. Potentially additional value for the contingency fund. More risk means you have to maintain a more contingencies, or you have to maintain more reserves to meet with the risk, right? But hopefully what will happen, if new changes are introduced, it will somewhere, it will, you are making changes so that you can make a, you know, smooth flow of work, to make a smooth functioning of the project, isn't it? Ya usme se koi uska risk kam ho jayega. And if these changes help you in reducing or mitigating the risk, then again your contingency fund or reserve ko fir se you'll bring it down, right? So it should be reduced, and the result of this change in scope and reduction in the risk reserves. And finally, how these changes affect the team. So what impact the change will have on the team? Sometimes what happens, the same team can handle the change, or sometimes you might need to add some people, and generally you want such people in the team who have those desired set of skills. Ki ya to aapko aapki already existing team mein wo skills introduce karni padengi, or the other way is ki you already introduce some people who already are well versed with those skills, right? So all the changes to approved project facts, no matter large or small, developing a way to deal with all kinds of changes and ensure that all changes are effectively integrated into the total project, So that means the schedule, budget, risk, and the team. It gets well fitted into all these aspects, be it schedule or be it budget, and wherever the quality, communication, everywhere it should be fitting, and you should be integrating those changes. So every aspect of the project needs to be addressed with the integrated change and present overall change picture, not in isolated changes. So overall picture with the changes is to be presented. We don't focus on those minor and individual changes or isolated changes, right? After that, we have scope verification. See, when we talk about scope verification, this scope verification is not verifying what we're delivering to the scope of the project, right? Ki hum kya deliver karenge, that is part of your scope control. So scope verification is ensuring that deliverables or the outcome which comes out of the project satisfy the scope that finally acceptance is going to be approved. We are focusing ki whatever outcome it is coming, it has to be accepted, it has to be approved at the end. Otherwise, all your project, whether it has gone through 1 year or 2 years, all your efforts will go in vain if at the end it doesn't get approved or it is not as per the standards or as per the expectations, right? So it is an ongoing and incremental review process in scope verification, incremental in the sense in between. So what do? We keep on checking the interim dividends. Interim means, you remember, there is annual dividend, there is interim dividend. Interim means anything which is given before the annual one. Annual hum sirf yearly pay karte hain. So if we are doing it annual basis verification, it will take time. Interim also, in between also, we have to keep on reviewing our project, right? So we have to keep on reviewing the interim deliverables also, and the work in process is also reviewed. So with the business unit, we keep on reviewing it to ensure that it will be introduced if some changes are required at the interim level itself, and then satisfy the final expectations and ensure that final project, when it comes out or when it is delivered, will satisfy the total requirements, right? So if you do good scope verification, right, ensuring that all interim and all work in process is reviewed on the ongoing basis, then obtaining a formal acceptance, it becomes very easy. Because you have reviewed it timely and thoroughly. So when the final deliverable is presented to the business for formal acceptance, it becomes a routine matter of the fact. Because in routine also you are reviewing the project. So wo at par the expectations ja hi raha hai. And so there is no question arises ki at the end ki wo reject ho jayega. It becomes a routine. Of course, we are going to approve your project deliverable. Of course, we are going to sign off your project. This is what your top management would be saying, isn't it? Because they also know that this is how you deal with, as a project manager, this is how you deal with your projects. So they'll say, we know we have to sign off. It will come. We have to give the final acceptance. And there's no question arising that we will reject or we will not accept your final acceptance, right? So obtaining formal acceptance becomes a part of routine. So ongoing monitoring, project control in terms of scope verification process ensures that final deliverable, final project acceptance will happen in a timely and efficient manner. In timely and efficient fashion, it can be done. After that, we talk about the control. In control, we talked about, I gave you a brief about it, outline of the control. We talk about scope, we talk about schedule, we talk about budget. So control is a very key aspect of any project monitoring and control process. Why? Because in control, we need to be sure that we have total control or we have the absolute understanding of the scope. See, if the team is working as per the scope, we want to ensure that there is no gold plating or there is no embellishment. Whatever the actual thing is there, whatever the exact thing is there, that is only getting projected, right? So that polishing should not be there. So we are, that means we are delivering exactly what the project specifications are going to be. We are not making any change, or we are not, we are not making it ostentatious that it is just showing up something else and exact things are very different. It's not that. For each and every task which is being performed under the scope of project management. So whether the task is being produced according to the original set schedule, or we're going to effectively monitor and manage a critical path for the task, ensuring that a variation is dealt with. You remember those critical paths, CPM and PERT? What it does? It talks about the path or the, you know, chain of activities which are to be followed and how much time is assigned to each activity. So everything is to be done according to that. And this is how the exact things are going on. If it is going as per, the same thing is to be shown, right? So we need to very carefully and very diligently, we need to monitor the scope, schedule and the budget of the project, because otherwise it can affect you the total things, you know, it can affect you the total budget also, total cost of the project, and it can affect you the total time also. Next, we talk about quality control. So when we talk about quality control, we talk about that what was defined. What was defined means what was set as a standard, or what was the benchmark which we have set, that this is the kind of quality work we want to achieve from this project, right? So according to the scope meets acceptance criteria, properly tested and validated each product should be. You know, we need to make sure that first of all, our quality is falling under the scope. Secondly, it meets the acceptance criteria. Kiske bina wo acceptance approve hogi hi nahi. Then secondly, all the products, all the activities need to be very well tested and evaluated, so that a final validation can be given. The only way to ensure that quality is being followed is that these are properly evaluated timely, and these are also tested from time to time, right? So no business. After that, we have the performance reporting. When we are talking about performance reporting, see, we said that whatever has been done till now, we try to gather that information, we try to process that information, we try to, then finally we try to distribute it to the outside world. Outside world means, we said that it means the people who are interested in it or who are a part of the project. So whatever is being done as a part of the project, when it needs to be reported out, that is you just reporting, you are gathering, you are consolidating all the actual details from the team members, so that you can communicate the same information to the appropriate or concerned stakeholders in the organization, you know. So from each member, suppose they are in a team, they are 5 members. You need to take the information from each member individually. From team 1, you got the information A, B, C, D, E. From another team member, he gave you some information on P, Q, R, S, T. What would happen? You'll collect the individually information from each team member, and then finally you'll consolidate it together. You'll prepare a summary, and that would give you the actual picture of the actual performance, the exact picture of the actual performance which is happening in the project work, right? So, and then you keep a track of this project status, that how project is going. Because you have 1 team member or 2 team members, they can be a little biased, or they can lie to you. They might not tell you the true picture. So for that, you individually collect it from everybody, and then you summarize it and reach to a conclusion. So you develop project forecast. Project forecast in the sense on the basis of the consolidated report which you have gathered from different team members, you try to, you know, forecast the future, that what all things can be there, what all issues can come up, and if things are going little deviated from the actual standards or actual line, then you can revise those forecast ki now we were not expecting that so and so thing will come up, but cheeje thodi alag chal rahi hain, so there is a possibility now this new thing might come up, so you need to revise your forecast so that project when you revise you'll get to know ki nahi things are little going little slower, so our project might be delayed by 5 days or 7 days or 10 days, and then this new picture of where we are now and what is going to be the new completion time, right? So this new picture is your, you'll get it from after tracking the project status, okay? And this is to be reported further then to the concerned stakeholders that we were expecting to finish this project within this much budget by, say, by the end of December, but now we are expecting as per the progress of the report they can be a delay of 7 days or 10 days, right? After that we have risk monitoring and control. Risk monitoring and control means whether, see, if you are able to complete your project within the time and within the budget, then that means there is no risk, right? It is perfectly risk free that whatever you had planned you are going. Risk comes when there is a deviation that ya to aap timely use complete nahi kar paoge ya aap usko within budget complete nahi kar paoge, then risk arises, isn't it? So for risk, what do? We proactively we manage and eliminate the unknown problems. Unknown problems means the expected problems, but there are some problems which cannot be avoided. Suppose we are expecting that during the project duration there will be a festive season of Diwali. So we know that for 1 week our labor will not be working. There will be no labor available. There will not be any work happening. So some things are unavoidable. You cannot change that. So that already you have to take a proactive approach towards it. कि या तो आप उसको अभी speed increase करवा दो, या फिर already you add that time into your total project schedule, or you increase 1 hour every day. And you take a proactive action. Proactive means anything you do in advance. So some things you can avoid, some things are unavoidable. You act on the present risk which is there in your hand. We categorize the risk, we prioritize the risk, ki jo sa bhi immediately in hand hai, that we deal with first. After that, give me 2 minutes. So we prioritize the risk on a basis of a timeline, ki which are just at present they are affecting, which will be affecting in the coming week, which will be affecting in the coming months, and which will be affecting after 2 months, 3 months, so on, right? Then we act on the current risk first, because these will be having the immediate effect, right? Then we identify the new risk. Identify new risk means we'll be looking at the probable risk. Those are which will have the bad impact on our project, right? These are negative unknown risk. Then we have retire risk. Retire risk in the sense that which we were assuming as a risk, but now it is not affecting us. Suppose in the beginning we had taken that what if our team is not skilled enough and team needs to be trained. If our team needs to be trained, then we need to invest some money in their training. So it will affect the total cost of the project. But now we realize ki project is going very swiftly as per the expectations and no team or no training is required. So whatever the amount of reserves we had set aside, it has become a retired risk now. This risk has retired. We need not to deal with it. So now those contingency funds or those reserves will not be consumed for the training of the employees or the training of the project team, right? Then in the end, we have the last contract administration, the last step in project monitoring and control. See, we said that contract administration is what? First, it ensures that it adheres to the contract. Contract in the sense, see, every contract is two-sided, isn't it? When an agreement gets accepted at both the sides, by both the parties, then it takes the form of legal binding and it becomes a contract, right? So that means it is not only that only if you are dealing with your sellers or vendors, there is an obligation on the seller side also, but also on the project manager or the project team, obligation is also there from both the sides. So it is an obligation on the head of the project manager that he abides by all the rules and regulation of the contract, whether it is related to the approvals or the payments. Timely payment is to be done to the sellers and vendors and the suppliers, right? So, and the approval and payment work is to be done in the sense that process approval and payments, prompt processing should be done. Prompt payment should be made to the vendors and the suppliers. So project manager is managing and administering the contracts within a project. Getting all the contracts. And usme bahut sari parties hoti hain. They can be umpteen number of sellers and dealers and vendors and suppliers you are dealing with. So, and project manager is managing all these contracts. That whatever the terms and conditions were there when you entered into the contract, he is making sure that all those terms and conditions are met and have been followed. And he is taking all the actions for making the prompt payments and prompt processing of the order and everything. So when he is managing all the contracts within a project, so it is like, you know, managing a mini project within a project. You have a big project within that, dealing with all the contract dealers and suppliers and everything. You are managing a small or tiny project within a project. So that's all about project monitoring and controlling. Okay. So all these are interrelated steps, interrelated phases. The first, we start with the monitoring the project, monitoring and controlling the project work. After that, we try to integrate whatever the changes are happening, whether it is large or small, all kinds of changes are to be integrated. Then we try to verify the scope. In verifying the scope, we focus on the acceptance, that final outcome gets accepted. Then we talk about the control. In control, we talk about the scope, time, and the budget. Okay. Then we have perform quality control. Perform quality control in the sense, whatever the quality assurance was done at the execution level, now we are making sure that quality is ensured and it is being adopted and taken as a part of every task or every activity which is taking place in the project work right now. Then we report whatever the performance, how the project is going, how it is doing. That is to be reported to the outside world. And we are making sure the exact or true picture is being reported back. Okay, there is no gold plating in it. Then we talk about the monitoring and controlling the various kinds of risk that is acting on current risk or identifying the new risk, or if there are some retired risk, then we can calculate the total results, how it will be impacted, right? Then there is a contract compliance. Contract compliance means the administering all the contracts a project manager has to deal with. He has to administer, manage all the contracts which have been made with the parties outside the organization, right? So with this, we finish our monitoring and control. That's all for today's class. If you have any queries, you can ask.